If you're looking to build a new PC, you've come to the right place. Howdy, howdy guys, Ponchato here, and welcome to Monthly Builds for March of 2018. In these videos, I show you the parts I'd use for building gaming PCs at $500, $750, and $1,000 budgets. To keep up with new prices and components, I put up a new video every month, except last month, so be sure to subscribe to stay up to date. The good news is, this month there actually isn't much good news. GPUs are still expensive from cryptocurrency mining, RAM is still expensive from shortages, and SSD prices are stagnant. I'm not gonna lie, building a PC now kinda sucks, but that doesn't mean you should put off building or upgrading. Prices have pretty much only gone up for more than a year, and I fully expect that to continue. If you wait, it'll probably just get more expensive. We've all been waiting for prices to come back to normal for more than a year now, but this may be the new normal. I really hope I'm wrong about that, but everything I've seen recently says that I'm not. Prices aside, there hasn't been much movement in the PC hardware market other than AMD's launch of the Ryzen APUs. In a nutshell, these are just Ryzen processors with integrated Vega graphics. I have a Ryzen 5 2400G sitting on the desk next to me as I record this, so expect a full benchmark video including overclocking results very soon. Now, what you came here for, let's dive into the builds. First up, the $500 build. For the CPU, I went with the newest addition to AMD's lineup, the Ryzen 3 2200G for $100. It's a quad-core running at 3.5 GHz with a 3.7 GHz turbo clock and built-in Vega 8 graphics, though we'll be using a dedicated GPU for this build. It comes with AMD's very capable Wraith cooler, and it's unlocked, so if you go with an overclock-ready motherboard, you'll be able to push this CPU even faster. Paired to that, I went with EVGA's GTX 1050SC for $150. The 1050 is still a great choice for budget builds since it can easily handle low to medium settings in most titles at 1080p. On top of that, it's only a 75 watt card, so it doesn't require an extra power connector and it won't produce much heat or noise. For the motherboard, I picked ASRock's A320M-HDV for $50. It's pretty bare bones, but has everything you need for a budget build. Two RAM slots, an M.2 slot for SSDs, and it's a micro ATX board, so it'll fit in just about any case. Memory comes from the ever-trusty Corsair, their Vengeance 2x4GB kit for $90. This is a 2400MHz kit, and though Ryzen processors do like faster memory, you can still get more than enough performance at this speed. Storage will be handled by the Seagate BarraCuda 1TB drive for $45. Plain, simple, and cheap. Power will come from EVGA's 450BT for $40. It's an 80 plus bronze power supply with a 3-year warranty and sleeved cables, so it's perfect for a budget build like this. Finally, for the case, I went with the Rosewill FBM-01 Micro ATX for $25. At this budget, the main requirement for the case is just that it's functional while being as inexpensive as possible. After all, until you're dealing with high-end and high-heat CPUs and GPUs, the case is essentially unrelated to gaming performance. You just need something that can hold everything together, and this one does exactly that. All told, this build hits its mark at exactly $500. If you want to get into PC gaming or just want to conquer your first build, this build is a great starting point. If you want to pick up any or all of these parts, links are in the description below. Next up, we'll look at the $750 build. If you have a bit more to throw at a computer right now, this is what I'd consider the sweet spot. For the CPU, I went with Intel's G4560 for $61. The CPU has managed to keep up an incredible price to performance ratio through its entire existence, with two cores and four threads running at 3.5 GHz and a ridiculously low price for what you get. Paired to that, I went with the Gigabyte GTX 1060 3GB for $360. The 1060 has been the go-to for mid-range gaming basically since its release and can handle just about any gaming you throw at it at 1080p and even 1440p. This one comes with a dual fan cooler, so it'll stay cool and quiet even during long gaming sessions. The motherboard will come from Gigabyte, their GA-B250M-DS3H, for $60. It has the full complement of features you'd want in a mid-range gaming build, 4 DIMM slots to add more memory, 2 extra PCIe x1 slots for add-in cards like a wireless AC adapter, and an M.2 slot which we'll be using for the SSD. For the memory, I picked two sticks of the Ballistix Sport LT 2666 for $100. Intel CPUs aren't as memory dependent as Ryzen, but there is still a gain to be had from faster memory, and the slight price bump here is worth it. The SSD will be ADATA's SU800 M.2 for $48. It's 128GB, which is enough for a Windows 10 install plus one or two games, and having Windows on an SSD will dramatically improve system boot times and responsiveness. For bulk storage, I picked the Seagate BarraCuda 1TB for $45. Big and cheap, not much else to say about this drive. Power comes from Thermaltake Smart 500 for $40. In the realm of budget power supplies, this one is hard to beat. 80 plus rated, 5-year warranty, and to top it off, it's actually pretty quiet. Oh, and the cables are all sleeved, no ugly ketchup and mustard colors to deal with. Finally, for the case, I picked the Rosewill SRM-01 for $30. This was a bit of a sacrifice in order to fit the budget, but this case does look decent and has space for a 120mm fan up front if you want to improve airflow later. Altogether, this build landed just under the budget at $749. If you were eyeing the $500 build but can swing a bit larger budget, I definitely recommend going for the $750 build. If you want to pick up any or all of these parts, links are in the description below. Now, if your budget allows for even more, check out the $1,000 build here. For the CPU, I picked AMD's Ryzen 5 1500X for $155. It's a 4-core, 8-thread processor running at 3.5 GHz and comes with AMD's beefy Wraith Spire cooler. Like all the Ryzen processors, it's unlocked, which means you can overclock it out of the box, and the included cooler offers some pretty hefty overclocking headroom. Paired to that, I picked the NVIDIA GTX 1060 6GB for $450. The 6GB model offers better longevity due to the extra 3GB of VRAM, and actually has a slightly faster GPU than the 3GB model, offering around 10% faster performance. For the motherboard, I went with ASRock's AB350M-HDV for $65. It has an M.2 slot for the SSD we'll be adding, and since it's a B350 chipset, this motherboard will allow you to overclock the Ryzen 5 for some free performance gains. For the memory, I picked the speedy Corsair Vengeance 2x4GB kit for $112. This kit runs at 3000 MHz, which is perfect for Ryzen processors since they're so dependent on memory speed. For the SSD, I chose ADATA's surprisingly inexpensive SX6000 NVMe drive for $53. NVMe offers significantly faster read and write performance than SATA, so this is a great option if you're looking for maximum performance without spending way too much on a single drive. Bulk storage again goes to the Seagate BarraCuda 1TB hard drive, which should offer enough space for just about any gamer. For power, I picked Seasonic's Focus Plus 550FX for $68. This is a fully modular 80 plus gold power supply with a feature I absolutely love. Below about 30% load, it can run fanless. I've reviewed the 850FX, which is the big brother to this one, and you can check out that by clicking the card in the top right of this video. Finally, for the case, I went with a reliable classic, Cooler Master's N200 for $40. It has a full mesh front panel, supports a 240mm radiator up front, and comes with two 120mm fans, one up front for intake and one in the back for exhaust. The total for this build comes to a comfortably under budget $993. This build will last a good number of years without needing an upgrade, and when you do decide to upgrade in the future, you'll have a good foundation to build from. If you want to pick up any or all of these parts, links are in the description below. So that's it for monthly builds of March 2018. If you're building a PC for the first time, welcome to the community, and be sure to check out my build videos to see how it's done. If you're a veteran and just needed to catch up, I hope these recommendations helped you. If you want to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up, hit subscribe and click the bell icon to enable notifications. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions on these builds or the parts I chose, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.